gets to her, has this character called the Bag. It was almost like the unknown comic at the time. He used to crack the guys and kiss them, you know, and they always wanted the Bag. You know, Ace Frehley used to go, "Hey, are you gonna have the Bag tonight?"
Bring the Bag over here. Where's the Bag, Howie? Where's the Bag?
The Bag was just like, would pop up every once in a while, not that often. It was just a face drawn on a big laundry bag. You know, they had these paper laundry bags in the beautiful Holiday Inns we used to stay in. And I would pull, you know, make two holes for eyes and draw a stupid face on it and wear sweatpants and stick my arms through the sweatpants so only my hands came out at the knee and have the bag on. And the bag would talk like this. And the bag was always drunk and really smart and knew everything. And made a lot of, you know, suggestions to people in the room. And the running commentary for a couple hours.
And usually the Bag appeared in Ace Frehley's room.
Yeah.
Almost always in Ace Frehley's room. The Bag would come over and entertain Ace.
Could most everybody else would be very upset with the Bag.
Well, Gene would be upset.
Gene was very, very upset with the Bag.
Yeah.
And that made Ace even happier.
Ah, baloney.
Gene was straight. He wasn't high like we were. So it had he had a different sense of reality when he came into Ace's room, you know. We were, like, drinking and smoking and generally being idiots. And Gene came in one time, and there were these two girls that were looking at the Bag, like, wondering, who's that guy? Why has he got that thing on his head? So one of them went over and tried to remove it. Well,
the Bag went berserk.
Well, when you try to remove the Bag from the Bag, that's cause for immediate ejection from the hotel room. So I threw them out. And Gene was very upset about that, because that's the only reason he was in the room, was because there were two girls.
And it was Ace's room.